Hello students, welcome to e-classes of T.N. Amarsay High School. We will continue with our chapter number 10, Mensuration.
Question number 8 of exercise 10.1. Find the perimeter of a regular hexagon with each side measuring 8 meter. Students, here we have to find the perimeter of a regular hexagon and the measure of each side of the hexagon is 8 meter. Now solution for sum number 8, here we have to find out the perimeter of regular hexagon. To find out the perimeter of regular hexagon, the formula is perimeter of hexagon is equal to 6 multiplied by side, and side is given in the question as 8 meter. So here we will write 6 multiplied by 8. By multiplying 6 and 8, we will get 48 meter as an answer. Therefore, perimeter of regular hexagon is 48 meter. Question number 9. Find the side of the square whose perimeter is 20 meter. Students, here what is given in the question is that the perimeter of the square is 20 meter. We have to find the measurement of the each side of square. Now solution for sum number 9. Here the perimeter of the square is equals to 4 multiplied by side. And the perimeter of the square given in the question is 20. So in the place of perimeter of the square, we will write 20 is equals to this 4 multiplied by side, we will write here. So to find out the side, we will divide this 20 by 4. Side is equals to 20 divided by 4. And by dividing 20 by 4, we will get 5 as an answer. So side is equals to 5 meter. Therefore, the side of the square is 5 meter. Student, try to solve question number 10 of exercise 10.1 by yourself now. Question number 11. A piece of a string is 30 cm long. What will be the length of each side if the string is used to form A, a square, B, an equilateral triangle, C, a regular hexagon? Students, here what is given in the question is that the piece of a string is 30 cm of length, and if the string is used to form a square, then what will be the length of each side? And if the string is used as an equilateral triangle, then what will be the length of each side? And if the string is used in the form of a regular hexagon, then what will be the length of each side of the hexagon? Now solution for sum number 11. Now A part of sum number 11, we have to find out the length of each side of a square if the string is used in the form of a square. So here first we will write perimeter of the square, that is 30 cm, which is given in the question. Now perimeter of the square is equals to 4 multiplied by side. Now here in the place of perimeter of the square, we will write this 30 equals to 4 multiplied by side. We will write here as it is. Now 30 is equals to 4 multiplied by side. Now if we have to find out this side, we will divide this 30 with 4, and here we will write side is equals to 30 divided by 4. Now by dividing 30 by 4, we will get 7.5. So side is equals to 7.5 cm. Therefore, length of each side is 7.5 cm if the string is used in the form of a square. B part of question number 11. Here, if the string is used in the form of an equilateral triangle, so perimeter of an equilateral triangle is equals to 30 cm, which is given in the question, and perimeter of an equilateral triangle is equals to 3 multiplied by side. The formula to find of equilateral perimeter of equilateral triangle is 3 multiplied by side. So in the place of perimeter of an equilateral triangle, we will write 30, and this 3 multiplied by side we will write here as it is. 30 is equals to 3 multiplied by side. And to find out the side, we will divide this 30 by 3. 30 divided by 3 is 10. So side is equals to 10 cm. Therefore, length of each side is 10 cm if the string is used in the form of an equilateral triangle. Now solution for C part of sum number 11. Here we have to find out the length of each side if the string is used in the form of a hexagon. So first I will write down perimeter of a regular hexagon, that is 30 cm. And to find out perimeter of regular hexagon, the formula is 6 multiplied by side. Here in the place of perimeter of regular hexagon, we will write this 30 is equals to 6 multiplied by side, we will write here, that is 30 is equals to side multiplied by 6. Now to find out the side, we will divide this 30 by 6. Side is equals to 30 divided by 6. By dividing 30 by 6, we will get 5. So side is equals to 5 cm. Therefore, length of each side is 5 cm. Students, with this we end our today's video and will continue with our chapter in the next video. Thank you.